What is this? It could be food poisoning or something worse. Don't touch your faces.
This season, we have this episode, which, you know, there's this dysentery that hits the ridge, and Claire obviously gets very, very ill. And for Jamie, this is pretty horrific. You know, I think he's always used to being the strong one. You know, for him to lose her, it's one of his biggest fears.
Drink some ice.
When Claire's in her fevered state, Mrs. Bug and Malva cut all her hair off, as they think that that's something that will help a fever. But apparently it's a real trauma for Jamie.
He saw it.
What did he say?
He didn't say anything. He just cried.
I'm sure he keeps a little lock of her hair somewhere.
So, you know, the King of Men has one Achilles heel. He's shallow as all hell.
As the revolution's going, there's the term, the shot heard around the world. And for us on the ridge, as we're kind of paralleling the American Revolution, our shot is when Malva walks in to Fraser's Ridge with Tom and Alan and accuses Jamie of being the father of her unborn child.
It was him. It was a really tough day. It was a very long scene. It almost felt like the theater again or something, because it was very long. It was strung out. The tension was kind of built, and she's just a wreck.
I'm so sorry, Mistress Fraser. We didn't mean to hurt you. What the hell is she talking about?
Obviously, that is a huge shock to Claire. Deep down, she knows it's not true. But she did have that fevered dream where she did see them together in the room. So there's a kernel that plants a sort of seed of doubt in her mind.
He took me.
It's one of those scenes that you look forward to the day on the schedule, because you know that everyone has to bring their A game, because there's a lot of emotion at play.
No need for that now. Isn't there? He's made a whore of your daughter.
And I get to swing a fist at Jamie. Yeah, I mean, you've seen the size of me. I'm tiny, so I think I glance a punch.
Then we'll draw up a contract. Maintenance for her and the bear.
Tom tries to do what he thinks is right. He tries to play it by the book, but inside he's broken.
I suppose you could take the bastard for your wife to rear. That is your business.
Get out.
It's completely shocking for Jamie, and obviously for Claire. You know, Claire leaves the room in disgust and confusion. So they have to really work through that together.
Do you believe me about Malva?
Yes.
It's a very pivotal moment, and really is the beginning of the end of Fraser's Ridge, in a sense.
When she comes out and she tries to hear me out and I'm chopping the axe.
I think you're a young woman who made a mistake. But it wasn't with my husband.
Perhaps it was he who made the mistake, and now I'm carrying the blame for it. She can't take the love because she's been told by all the men in her life that you're not worthy. You're not worthy of love. And Claire shows that to her. And so when she goes back on that and she realises I've gone against the one person who actually had faith in me, then she's disgusted with herself.
Young Ian is completely cut up about what has happened. The whole thing is spiralling out of control. And he's thinking, what can I do to help? What can I do to help? And as he does so often, tries to be as noble as he possibly can be.
I'll marry her. I'll be a husband and a father. I'll do it for the bairn's sake.
But there's other characters with ulterior motives that even young Ian's best intentions will not fix.
Wake up. I prep quite a lot with my scripts, but with this scene, it's not necessarily Malva. It's Claire's version and Claire's biggest fears. You know, when you have a dream of, you know, and your biggest fears come to play, and they're so magnified, and it's terrifying. It was that I had to get in the mind frame of that. So it was really the kind of darkest form of Malva.
I'll have him. It's the kind of nightmare that you have that really shakes you, where you're like, oh, did that happen? Did that not? I don't feel good. And so she goes outside to the garden, and that's when she discovers this murdered body. And it's so traumatic. I mean, it was such a traumatic scene to film. I think, you know, those tiny threads that she was holding on to the last bits of her sanity just snapped.